So you want to make a fast and reliable site. You just throw a CDN in front of it, right? Is that all you need to do? Well, there's a little bit more to it when you think about having a global audience, global customer base. And I want to walk through this post from our CTO, Malta. Effortless high availability for dynamic frontends. The last video I did where I walked through a blog post, y'all seem to really like. So I want to do another one of these. Talk about how Vercel keeps you safe and reliable and resilient against downtime. So Vercel's frontend cloud is designed for high availability and tries to protect you against large-scale regional outages at basically every layer of our architecture. So that's not only static files, that's also compute, which we're going to get into. So if it's Black Friday, for example, this is the difference between downtime or having a smooth operation if you're running a highly dynamic workload. And we've taken quite a bit of steps to try to make this easier. We have an architecture diagram here I can kind of walk through. So a user or a customer is making a request to your website. Vercel has a global Anycast network that's going to automatically set up load balancing for you. We have multiple different points of presence across our globally distributed network. And then there's also a smaller number of Vercel regions. I believe we have 18 where we then route traffic to. Now, this brings up a good question, which I'm sure we'll talk about more, but why have fewer regions versus, I don't know, 400 regions? And the great thing is that you can have higher cache hit ratios in those 18 regions that we have while still having a bunch of points of presence as well, too. Going even further down the stack, we have our functions, which have multiple availability zones, and then they're actually talking to your backend region, or in the case of a regional outage, going to a failover region. So a lot to digest in there, but it's a high density, high quality diagram. So optimized global routing. So users make requests to Vercel sites with our global Anycast routing system, connecting them to the nearest edge network region. So this is going to ensure that traffic is efficiently directed to any of our primary regions, the 18 that I talked about. So even if certain network components are temporarily offline, our system can automatically reroute users to the nearest operational region so that you can, and you and your customers can see sites without disruption. So if Frankfurt is separated from the internet through a fiber cut, traffic would go to Paris. And then if Paris has an issue, then the traffic moves to London and so on. So we've taken extreme measures here to help protect your customers. And this is not only for just general traffic or static assets. We support globally distributed edge compute as well too. But typically what we see customers do is they run their primary compute on Vercel directly close to their data source. And usually that's one to maybe three regions, depending on what their replication strategy looks like. It really makes a lot of sense when the backend is like a database or an API gateway or an e-commerce platform, for example. So you want to co-locate your data with your compute for the lowest latency. And we also have multi-availability zone and multi-region redundancy. So Vercel functions can be deployed across multiple availability zones by default in any single region. So inside of US East, for example, there's multiple availability zones, which is great. That makes their availability even higher. But cross availability zone, full region outages do happen sometimes. And function failover is something that our enterprise customers can activate directly through the dashboard and provision functions in a backup region. So it's really nice because this active passive setup can ensure that function invocations are instantly redirected to the backup region during this type of incident and offer robust protection against full regional downtimes. So when Frankfurt falls off the face of the earth or US East falls off the face of the earth, you can rest safely knowing that you're protected there. There's also other advanced configuration here. So maybe it's helpful if there's multiple primary regions are used, or you really want to have control of what the specific backup region is, maybe for some compliance regions or where your main data source is located. You can also control that too. And yeah, data residency laws, which is basically compliance. Okay, simplified backend failover protection with edge config. The final bit here for highly available frontends is edge config, which is our super fast data store. Edge config allows pushing these configuration updates to your global compute fleet with minimal latency and also without ever needing to redeploy. So if you need to fail over your application to some backup system, this is a good storage solution for that task. So Let's say, for example, your primary database has an outage and you're failing over to a read replica. Well, edge config can reroute your compute to use that new database address. So imagine a headless e-commerce site or a CMS vendor has a regional outage. You can also then reroute your compute to its backup location. The final note of this post is that highly available multi-region cloud infrastructure, it's kind of a mouthful, but it's important. It's kind of difficult and can be expensive to set up as well too. So we're trying to make it as easy as possible, give you the configuration options you need, and also try to make it cost effective, both at the multi-availability zone layer, as well as for the more advanced customers, also the multi-region layer as well too. So hopefully this was interesting and a little bit deeper dive into what Vercel's Edge Network is doing for you to help keep your sites resilient and online. If you want to see more engineering dives like this, we're cooking up some great posts. So let me know in the comments what you'd like to see. Peace.